In this video, I want to talk about the fetal skull. Now, when working with the fetal skull, we have to remember we can't remove all of the soft tissue as we did in the adult skull, because the fetal skull is actually held together with membranes, and if we remove those membranes, the fetal skull will fall into its various bones. But what we can notice on this fetal skull is that we have the two halves of the adult frontal bone. So here we have a frontal bone, and here we have a frontal bone, separated by a suture. In some people, that suture will persist as an adult. If it does, we call that a mitotic suture. In the majority of people, that suture grows over, and there's virtually no remnant of that suture remaining. Here we can see what would be the coronal suture in the adult, and there is a fontanelle where the two frontal bones and the two parietal bones meet, called the anterior fontanelle. A lot of people call that the soft spot. The anterior fontanelle is where the bones have not yet fused, and that allows for overlapping of these bones so that the skull can actually, I hate to use the word crush, but can compact in on itself as the fetus passes through the birth canal. We have an anterior fontanelle where the two frontal bones and two parietal bones meet, laterally where the temporal bone, occipital bone, and parietal bones meet, we have what is known as the mastoid fontanelle. So here we see the mastoid fontanelle. Notice also in the fetal skull that you are, of course, born without any teeth. But if we look carefully, there are some teeth within the mandible and the maxilla. They just have not actually broken through the surface yet. So there are teeth in the skull. They're very small. They are still forming. And then the bones of the orbit of the eye. So the fetal skull is a little bit distorted from the adult skull. Facial bones still have a lot of growing and forming to do. So the main features we want to see here are the anterior fontanelle and the mastoid fontanelle.